Good morning, everyone. So today we are starting with the problematic part of this module, that is Brayton's power cycle, that is gas power cycle. So especially in that Brayton cycle only is there in the entire syllabus. So we will go through the problems encountered in the Brayton cycle. So in the theory class, you studied about the basic Brayton cycle. Then to improve the efficiency, you have studied the Reed cycle, regenerative cycle, intercooling cycle, and combination of those things, that is intercooling with reheat and reheat with regeneration, then combination of all three, reheat, regeneration, then intercooling. So this many portion you studied in the theory class. So now you are solving the problem, how to solve. So basic steps, I will explain how to solve the problems each step by step. So basic idea of this problem, how to get the temperature point in the salient points. So you have the cycle, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 cycle, compression, then heat addition, then expansion, then heat rejection. Heat rejection part you leave, these three processes, that is compression, then heat addition, then expansion. These three processes are important. For these three processes, the four points 1, 2, 3, 4. How we have to get that temperature, that is the very important thing. So we will go forward. So we will go for the problem number one. So we will go for the problem number one. So what it states, in a simple gas turbine plant, air is compressed from 1 bar and 25 degrees centigrade through a pressure ratio of 4:1. It is then heated by 150 degrees centigrade in a combustion chamber and expanded back to atmospheric pressure of 1 bar in the turbine. Calculate cycle efficiency and turbine outlet temperature. So what the heck you want? Simple gas turbine plant, simple gas turbine power plant, that is the Brayton cycle of open type, because they are after your in this sentence they are given, after expanding it is sent back to the atmospheric, so it is not again circulating, hence we are having the open type of gas turbine. So in a open type of gas turbine, what will happen? First, we have the compressing the air from the surrounding air. Surrounding temperature and pressure condition they are given, that is P1. This one is P1, 1 bar pressure. That is the initial condition of your air. Initial condition of air they are given, that is 1 bar and 25 degrees centigrade. So P1 they are given, T1 they are given. Then it is going to the compression process. So what will happen? From 1 bar to, it is compressed to a certain point. But they are not given the outlet pressure, but in terms of pressure ratio they are given. Pressure ratio is nothing but 4:1. What do you mean by pressure ratio? Pressure ratio is nothing but outlet pressure by inlet pressure. That is nothing but P2 by P1. P2 by P1 they are given 4:1. In that already P1 you know, so that is 1. So that means P2 also 4 bar. So PR they are given. Once they are given PR, then no issues. 4:1. It is, see here, this sentence carefully read, after compression, whatever temperature is there, for that temperature, we have added 150 degrees centigrade. That is the meaning of this sentence. That is, it is then heated by 150 degrees centigrade. So, whatever temperature you get after the end of compression process, then it is going to the combustion chamber. So then 150 degrees centigrade you have added for this temperature in the combustion chamber. So that is the meaning of this sentence. Then it is expanded in the turbine. Then you are leaving your combustion product to the atmospheric pressure at 1 bar. So they told to find out cycle efficiency and turbine outlet temperature. So to find out efficiency and turbine outlet temperature. So whenever you encounter problem of this gas turbine, main thing is you have to find out the temperature. So now T1 only you know, rest temperature you have to know. So before that, we draw the TS diagram of Breton cycle. Simple gas turbine is nothing but Breton cycle. Simple Breton cycle. So first you draw the TS diagram of that one. So this is your Breton cycle. So 1 to 2 compression process, 2 to 3 your combustion process, that is the heat addition process in the combustor. Then 3 to 4 it is your expansion process in the turbine. 4 to 1 is the condenser, no need this part, you can join or you can avoid also, no issues. So these three parts are very important, 1 2 3 4. Now with respect to this TS diagram, with respect to this notation, what are the given data as initial condition? Initial condition means this one, that is P1 and T1, they are given. How much they are given? P1 is 1 bar, T1 is 25 degree centigrade. So then it is compressed. So compressed with the pressure ratio is 4:1. That is nothing but pressure ratio is nothing but P2 by P1. That is the given 4 bar. So pressure ratio 4:1. After reaching this temperature, then you have added 150 degree centigrade. That means first you have to find out the value of T2. Then T3 will be whatever you got value T2 plus 150 degree centigrade, that you have to add. Okay. Next, afterwards, what I given? Oh, sorry. Afterwards, you have to calculate how to calculate 1 to 2, which is that process? This is the isentropic process. So, you know, relationship between temperature and pressure, that is nothing but T2 by T1 is nothing but P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Or T2 is nothing but T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. This relation already you know this one in last class, means module 1 you have studied same relation, it will carry over here also. So advantage of this problematic part of this module 1, most of the temperature and pressure relation whatever you have studied in module 1, same thing will be there over here also. But here P2 by P1 represent pressure ratio, that something else, compression ratio, that will be there. So that you have to take care, that's it. So P2 by P1, that is a pressure ratio. So you can write instead of P2 by P1, PR you can write. So T1, you know, 25 degree centigrade, convert. Be careful over here. You have to convert everything degree centigrade into Kelvin. That is you have to add plus 273 over here. So T1 will be 298, pressure ratio, you know, gamma value, you know, for air it is 1.4, sorry, here it should be 1.4 by mistake. So you calculate, you will get T2. Once you got T2, then T3 will be, what is the value of T3? For this you add 150 degree centigrade, 150 degree centigrade, convert it into Kelvin, you will get T3. So T3 will be 150, sorry, here some mistakes happened. So 150 degree centigrade added, so Kelvin it have to be added. So next we have to find out, once you got the T3, next you have to get the value of T4 how to get? T4 again relation, you know, that is T4 by T3 is nothing but P1 by P2 or P1 also equals P4, P4 by P3, P4 by P3 also equals P1, because this is the constant pressure process, this is the constant pressure process. So P4 also equals P1. Remember this one. P4 also equals P1. This is the constant pressure process. P3 also equals P2. So that also you can write P1 by P2 or P2 by P1 represent PR. So and 1 by PR. So this equation you will get. T4 is nothing but T3 times 1 by PR to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T3 you got, just you add over here. So just substitute gamma 1.4, you will get value of T4. Once you got the value of T4, next what you have to do, whatever they are told, you have to find out, that is the cycle efficiency. Cycle T4 is nothing but your exhaust temperature, that is after turbine. 3 to 4 is the turbine process, so turbine outlet temperature is nothing but T4. So 3 to 4 is the turbine, so turbine outlet is nothing but T4. So T4 you have found out. Now next, only one thing is remaining, that is the cycle efficiency. How to find out cycle efficiency? Efficiency is nothing but network output divided by E-direct. Network output means what? That is turbine work, that is the positive work, minus compression work, that is the negative work. So WT minus WC divided by Q added. Q added will be for the process 2 to 3. So that is the equation. So now everything you have to write in terms of temperature. Equation you have to write in terms of temperature. So eta will be, that is efficiency, that is turbine work minus compression work, that is the net work, divided by E data. So turbine work, how to give the turbine work? Turbine work is over here, 3 to 4. So how to give in terms of temperature? Mass flow rate of this product, mass flow rate of this working fluid over here, multiply by Cp into temperature difference. Temperature difference meaning between 3, 4 is T3 minus T4. That is the turbine work. What is the compression work? Compression work is again mass flow rate of air. See, in the compression only air will be there. But 2 to 3, what will happen here? Heat added, that is burning of the fuel take place. So what will happen here? Fuel plus air will be there. Then fuel plus air will be over here also there. So fuel plus air will be till over here it is there. Here only air will be added. So be careful about that one. In the later stage, I will explain that once again in the later stage. So mass flow rate multiply by Cp of air multiply by temperature difference. Temperature difference is nothing but T2 minus T1. So in this way, heat added will be again your mass flow rate into Cp into T3 minus T2. So that will be your heat added. So entirely this equation you can write in terms of temperature, that we have seen already in the theory part. So just once again we will explain. So this is how we will write mass flow rate, because we are not considering for unit mass flow rate. So hence it will be there 111 everywhere. So turbine work M into Cp into T3 minus T4. Similarly compression M into Cp into T2 minus T1. Heat added M into Cp into T3 minus T2. So this is how you can write your efficiency formula. Cp again it will get cancels, only temperature will remain. Now you value of T3 you know, value of T4 you know, value of T2 you know, value of T1 you know, T3, T2, everything you know, just substitute, get the value of efficiency. So this is how you will solve this problem. This is simple problem what I explained over here. So don't take much panic, just you use this relation and get the values of temperature. Once you get the values of temperature, just go through the theory how to write this one. I have told now, so similar way you have to write this equation. Once you practice, then this portion will be very easy for you. Okay, so go through this once again. First problem, simple problem. Next we will go for the, as the problem number increases, the difficulty level also increases. So next problem we will go. So this is the answers. That is nothing but your turbine outlet temperature, that is nothing but T4, and efficiency is nothing but 32.71. Next problem. So what it states, in a gas turbine power plant, air is compressed from, so initial condition they have given, that is P1 in terms of kilopascal, 98.1 kilopascal and 15 degrees centigrade T1, through a pressure ratio they have given, that is PR 4:1. It is then heated to 650 degrees centigrade, that is nothing but T3 direct value they have given, T3 650 degrees centigrade in a combustion chamber. Remember, now they are given direct value of T3. Don't add it from T2. Now they are given ET2. Means air is maximum temperature will be your 650 degrees centigrade. That is the meaning of this sentence. So T3 they are given directly and then expanded back to the atmospheric pressure in the turbine. So once again it is bring back to the initial condition. Calculate cycle efficiency, work ratio, if the perfect gas exchanger is used. And then they are given the adiabatic efficiency of the turbine and compressor are 85 and 80% respectively. What do you mean by adiabatic efficiency? What do you mean by turbine efficiency? So this portion I have told in the theory part. That means the 1 to 2, whatever the straight line is there for compression, actual case you won't get that straight line. That means isentropic process is not possible to compress 1 to 2. Isentropic process, that is not possible. In actual case, there will be deviation. You will get like this curve for compression. So what is that deviation from theoretical to actual? That is nothing but your compressor efficiency. Similarly for turbine, 3 to 4, we are the straight line like this, 3 to 4. But in actual case, you won't get that kind of straight line. So you will get curved nature, 3 to 4. So actual and the theoretical, that will differ. So what is that difference? That is known as turbine efficiency. So that efficiencies are given, adiabatic efficiency and turbine efficiency, they are given. That is 85% and 80%. Okay. So now draw the TH diagram of this Brayton cycle. See, that is what I am telling. 1 to 2 is the compression theoretically. Remember, 1 to 2 that represent compression theoretically, but 1 to 2 dash that represent compression, actual compression. So instead of going like this, it is going like this. So actual cycle now 1 to 2 dash. Now it added will be from 2 dash to 3. Okay. 3 to 4 again turbine. So for the turbine actually you see theoretically will be like this 3 to 4. But actually it is happening now 3 to 4 dash. So this is the actual case. So this is the theoretical. Okay. Then 4 dash to 1 will be your actual. So now actual cycle is 1, 2 dash, 3, 4 dash, 1. Theoretical will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So this is the theoretical and this one is the actual. So when they are giving like that kind of things, how to proceed that one? Write down the given datas. Temperature, initial condition they are given, 15 degree centigrade, convert into Kelvin, 288 Kelvin. Pressure they are given 98.1 kilopascals, convert it into bar 0.98. Pressure ratio they are given PR and maximum temperature they are given, that is T3, okay, 650 degree centigrade. Next they are given efficiency, adiabatic efficiency of turbine, that is 85, and compressor they are given 80. So it should be turbine, eta turbine 85, eta compressor they are given 80. Okay, so next, as usual, you have to first find T2 over here rather than T2 dash, because you know the equation. Whenever it is isentropic, then you know the equation, that is T2 is nothing but T1 times PR to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, just I am just recalling PR is nothing but P2 by P1. Okay, T1 into PR power gamma minus 1 by gamma. T1 you know, that is 15 degree centigrade in terms of Kelvin, 288. PR you know 4, gamma you know 1.4, so substitute, get the value of T2. Once you got the value of T2, next step is to find out value of T2 dash. How to T2 dash you have to find it. What is that process? This is the process of compression. So in the compressor it will happen. So in the compressor, it is just the reverse of your turbine. Okay. Compressor efficiency is nothing but your ideal work divided by actual work. See, ideal work is nothing but T2 minus T1 divided by actual means T2 dash minus T1. So that is the formula for your compression. Whereas in the expansion or turbine, whatever it will be, it is just reverse. That is actual divided by theoretical. That is T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. So that is the thing. Just you remember, for compressor it is ideal work divided by actual work. This one is the ideal work, 2 and 1, 2 dash and 1, this is the actual. So ideal work divided by actual. So in this equation, eta compressor you know 80%, T2 you know, T1 you know. So just you need to find out T2 dash. Substitute and get the value of T2 dash. So just substitute and get the value of T2 dash. So just substitution for here. So you will get T2 dash is 462.95 Kelvin. So once you got the value of T2 dash, T3 value you know. So next you have to get the T4. How to get the T4? You have to use the relationship between temperature and pressure. Similar way, whatever you are used in the previous case. So that will remain same. That equation will remain same. So that is nothing but T4 is nothing but T3 times P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, or T3 equals T3 into 1 by PR to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this equation will remain same in every case. So once you remember this equation, then it will be very easy. So T3 value you know, that is the given 650. Convert it into Kelvin, that is 923 Kelvin. And PR value you know, gamma value you know, substitute and get the value of T4. Once you got the value of T4, then they are given the turbine efficiency is 85%. 85%. So what do you mean by turbine efficiency? Turbine efficiency is nothing but your actual divided by theoretical, actual work divided by theoretical work. So what do you mean by actual work? Actual work means 3 minus T4 dash. This is your actual, T3 minus T4 dash. What is the theoretical? That is T3 minus T4. Straight line will be always theoretical. Straight line is the theoretical. This curve line represent actual. Curve line actually represent actual process. So turbine efficiency is nothing but actual work divided by theoretical work. So in this equation, turbine you know efficiency 85%. T3 value you know, that is 923, that is your this value. Then T4 value you know, 621. So in this unknown is T4 dash. So just substitute everything, get the value of T4 dash. So after substitution and simplification, you will get T4 dash as 666.41. So now you got the actual value of temperature, T1, T2 dash, T3, T4 dash. So these values you know, now whatever the question they have asked, just find out. That is nothing but efficiency. Efficiency, turbine work minus compression work divided by eta dash. What do you mean by turbine work? Turbine work will become now T3 minus T4 dash. Remember, T3 minus T4 dash. Now everything is with respect to actual. Then compression work, T2 dash minus T1. It added T3 minus T2 dash, remember. Okay, so now with respect to actual, write the efficiency equation. That is net work output, turbine minus compression divided by it added. Turbine work, Cp times T3 minus T4 dash, remember. Compressor, Cp times T2 dash minus T1, and it added Cp times T3 minus T2 dash. So this is how you can write. Now all the temperatures you know, Cp value will get cancels and substitute and get the value of your this one efficiency. Efficiency is 17.74. You will get. So next they have asked work ratio. So work ratio means what? That is net work divided by positive work. So net work is nothing but Wt minus Wc divided by positive work is nothing but your turbine work. So Wt, Wt will get cancelled minus Wc by Wt. Wc is nothing but Cp times T2 minus T1, T2 dash minus T1. Your Wt is nothing but Cp times T3 minus T4. So just substitute this temperature and get the value of work ratio. So you will get this one. So final answer is your efficiency
and work ratio or efficiency will be 17.74 and work ratio will be 0.318. So this is how you are going to solve this problem. Okay, so next we will move on to third problem.
So what states? The following data refers to a gas turbine power plant. Maximum temperature. Maximum temperature, remember, where you will get maximum temperature? Sorry, here first they are given minimum temperature. So minimum temperature means T1. Initially condition itself is the minimum. T1 they are given. Maximum temperature they are given. Where it will happen? That is at T3. T3 is 580 degrees centigrade. Isentropic efficiency of the compressor, that already we have gone through now. Same way, compressor efficiency 86%. Isentropic efficiency of the turbine, turbine efficiency they are given 84%. Pressure ratio they are given PR. Ratio of specific heat, what do you mean by this one? This one is gamma. Gamma they are given, specific heat they are given CP. And effectiveness of heat exchanger they are given. So heat exchanger, that means they are given it is a regenerator cycle. Remember, whenever the heat exchanger will come into picture, that is nothing but regenerator cycle. Assuming the specific heat and gases remain constant, neglect the pressure loss in the pipes, determine efficiency with the heat exchanger and without heat exchanger. Okay, so now with the heat exchanger means with the regenerator, what is the efficiency of the cycle? Without a regenerator, what is the efficiency of the cycle? That you have to find out. Okay, so all the data, I think you have understood. This one is T1, this one is T3, eta compressor, eta turbine, PR, gamma, CP, and effectiveness of the heat exchanger. So draw the TS diagram. Draw the TS diagram. Okay, this one will be like this, like this. So this case you understood. Now heat exchanger they are given. That means actually if it is the perfect heat exchanger, so whatever the exhaust temperature is there, that will be the inlet. That will be the inlet for your combustion chamber. So this much heat will be taken from this exhaust. But since effectiveness is given, so your point will lie just below this one. Because effectiveness they are given, it is 75%. That means it is not 100% heat exchanger. So there will be a slight deviation or slight variation in the heat. So hence A point will lie just below this one. So this is actually heat supply from A to 3. So 2 dash to A, that much amount of heat it is taken from the exhaust gas. That is the meaning of heat exchanger. So this much amount of heat it is taken from the heat exchanger. From year to year it is the supply of heat. That is the heat added 3 to A. Okay. Now two cases while considering this heat exchanger, one more is without considering this heat exchanger. So now note down the given data. T1 they are given, T3 they are given, then compressor efficiency they are given, turbine efficiency they are given. Hence this won't be a straight line. In the actual case it is a curve. Okay, gamma and this one, PR value they are given, CP value they are given, and effectiveness of heat exchanger they are given. So this many data they are given. So as usual, first you find out T2, same equation, use the same equation, so substitute and get the value of your T2. Once you got the value of T2, what you have to do next? You have to find out value of T2 dash. How to find out value of T2 dash? Use the compressor efficiency. Compressor efficiency is nothing but your ideal divided by actual. Eta C is nothing but ideal, that is T2 minus T1. Actually is nothing but T2 dash minus T1. So eta C you know 0.86. Then T2 you know, T1 you know. T1 convert it into Kelvin. Remember here everything it should be converted into Kelvin temperature. So T2 dash is the unknown. So just substitute here the value of T2 dash. Once you got the value of T2 dash, T3 value you have to find out. How to find out T3 value?
sorry, T3 value that I given. Next, we have to find out value of T4. So using T3, just same relation, get the value of T4. So once you got the value of T4, next you have to find out T4 dash from the turbine equation. Turbine equation is nothing but actual divided by theoretical. Actually is T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. So substitute over here, unknown parameter will be T4 dash, rest everything you know. Just substitute and get the value of T4 dash. Once you got the T4 dash, next efficiency you have to find out without heat exchanger. Now we are not considering heat exchanger. So without heat exchanger, what is the efficiency? Efficiency formula, you know, that is a net work out divided by heat added. Net work means turbine work minus compression work. Turbine work is nothing but Cp times T3 minus T4 dash. Next, compression means Cp times T2 dash minus T1. Heat added, Cp times T3 minus T2 dash. So this will be your formula. Cp will get cancelled. Substitute the value of temperatures. So get the value of efficiency. Though this efficiency will be without heat exchanger. Now second case, with heat exchanger. So with heat exchanger means this much portion of heat will be less. So we have to calculate the exact temperature of this A. How to calculate that? They are given effectiveness of the heat exchanger. In this effectiveness of the heat exchanger, whenever we have the effectiveness or efficiency of the heat exchanger, one formula I gave in the theory class, I don't know how many of you remember, just one sentence I told, that one effectiveness, just remember that one. So that formula you have to use. So effectiveness of the heat exchanger or efficiency of the heat exchanger, it is given by temperature at this point TA minus T2 dash. So downwards, so whatever is the divided by T4 dash means this temperature divided by T2 dash. So in this efficiency, you know, that is 75%. You have to find out value of TA. T2 dash already you know. T4 dash is nothing but already you have found out. So all the other parameters you know, just unknown parameter will be TA. So once you find out from this equation, then it will be easy to calculate, because only changes will be this one, TA minus T2, T3 minus TA. Okay. So use this equation and get the value of TA. So TA will be 578.63. So just substitute. So once again, effectiveness formula, that is nothing but whatever the temperature you need to find out minus initial temperature T2 dash divided by, this is for perfect heat exchanger, T4 dash minus T2 dash. So this is how you will write the heat exchanger formula. Okay. Next, you have to substitute and get the value of TA. Once you got the value of TA, now Q added will be T3 minus TA. Remember, Q added only changes over here, T3 minus TA in the efficiency formula. Rest numerator will remain same. Denominator only changes. So T3 minus TA. Okay. So this temperature, instead of 458, you have to write 578. Then you have to calculate the efficiency. So you will get 25. So this is the efficiency without heat exchanger. This is the efficiency with heat exchanger. See how the improvement you can achieve by using the regenerator efficiency improvement. Okay. This is how you are going to solve. So final answer, note down, that is your efficiency without heat exchanger 17.4, with heat exchanger 25. Next problem, we will move on to next problem. I will go faster because these are the formulas, so again I won't explain. So these formulas will remain same. So only where it will changes, there only I will explain. Okay. So next problem, gas power plant, intake temperature pressure T1, P1, air is then compressed to a pressure, that is P2 they have given, that is 4.2 bar. So okay, the isentropic efficiency of the compressor given, eta C, temperature of the gas whose properties may be assumed to resemble those of air, is raised to 650, that is nothing but T3, maximum temperature is 650. Combustion chamber where the pressure will be drop. See here, P3. Remember, actually 2 to 3 is a constant pressure. Means once you get the value of P2, means P2 that is given 4.2, it has to be maintained entire during the combustion. But they are given, there will be pressure drop. That means P3 will be lesser than this pressure, 4.2 minus 0.086 bar. Just remember this sentence, combustion chamber where the pressure drop is this much. Expansion to the rest, everything is same. They are given, if the efficiency of the plant itself 18%, calculate the isentropic efficiency of the turbine. Means turbine efficiency you need to find. Mass may be neglected. Okay. The TS diagram. See, this will be the TS diagram. Remember, see, 2 to 3 actually constant pressure process, 2 to 3. Okay. But that is 4.2 bar. That is the given pressure for 2. Okay. But now they are given, from the 4.2 bar, some amount of pressure will be lost. That is 0.086. Okay. That means P3 pressure will be 4.2 minus 0.086. That is 4.114 bar. So that is the actual pressure of this one. So TS diagram, you have to show this difference. Okay. You have to show this difference, then only that TS diagram is valid. So make a note of that one, the pressure difference in this problem. Then rest, I think it is same as the previous problems. T1, T1, P2 they have given. Instead of pressure ratio, they have given compressor pressure, P2 bar. Then compressor efficiency they have given. Maximum temperature they have given, T3. P2, sorry, this should be P3 they are given, that is 4.114 bar. Eta of the cycle they are given, 18%. So first calculate pressure ratio, PR, that is nothing but P2 by P1, that is 4.2. okay, once you calculate P2, then find out T1, you know. So just find out T2, you know this equation, just substitute and get the value of T2. After T2, compressor efficiency they are given, so find out T2 dash. Okay, so compressor efficiency, that is ideal divided by actual. Okay, so you will get T2 dash. Once you got the value of T2 dash, T3 they are given, so T4 find out. T4 use the relation, same relation, then T4 dash. That is turbine efficiency they are not given, but the cycle efficiency they are given. So what you have to do, using the this efficiency, find out the value of T4 dash. Okay, so how to find out? Eta efficiency, you know, overall efficiency, that is nothing but turbine minus compressor efficiency divided by eta. Turbine efficiency is nothing but T3 minus T4 dash minus T2 dash minus T1. Eta added, T3 minus T2 dash. So in this equation, eta value you know, see 18%. T3 value you know, that is how much, 650 converted into Kelvin. T4 dash unknown, T2 dash known, T1 is known, T3 known, T2 dash known. So everything is known, only unknown will be T4 dash. Substitute and get the value of T4. T4 dash will be like this. So once you got the value of T4 dash, then you have to get the turbine efficiency formula. Turbine efficiency is nothing but turbine efficiency, that is actual, that is T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 by T4. So in this every temperature, you know, just substitute, get the value of turbine efficiency, 84%. So this is the answer you will get. Turbine efficiency is nothing but 84%. Okay, so this is how you will solve this problem. Okay, we'll move on to the next problem. Problem number 5. Air enters the compressor of an ideal standard Breton cycle at 100 kilopascal 300 kelvin. So that is the initial temperature and pressure P1 T1 with the volumetric flow rate they are given, that is mass flow rate in terms of volume basis 6 m³/s. Compressor pressure ratio they are given, PR they are given 10. Turbine inlet temperature, see turbine inlet temperature, that means value of T3. 3 to 4 is the turbine process, so T3 they are given. Determine thermal efficiency, work ratio, power developed. So they are not mentioned about anything about compressor efficiency or turbine efficiency, then no need of take care of that curve nature of TS diagram, just straight lines, okay. So draw the TS diagram. Just a straight line is enough. So no need to draw again curve over here because they are not mentioned anything in the question. So no need for that one. So 1 to 2 compression, 2 to 3 heat addition, 3 to 4 expansion in the turbine, 4 to 1 is the compression, heat rejection. Okay. 2 to 3 heat addition. So note down the given data as T1, P1 kilopascal is there, converted into bar. P2 they are given 10 bar. So T3 they are given 1500. So PR will be P2 by P1. That is 10 by 1. So that is nothing but 10. So once you know PR, find out value of T2. Same equation. Equation doesn't change. So once you remember this one, it will be very easy. T2. Okay, once you got the value of T2, next T3 value you know, so get the value of T4. So T4, use the same relation, you will get the value of T4. Okay, so next what you have to do, efficiency, same way, WT minus WC divided by E today. WT is nothing but CP times T3 minus T4, CP times T3 minus T4, compressor, CP times T2 minus T1, CP times T2 minus T1, heat addition, CP times T3 minus T2. So you will get this one. So you will get this the formula. Okay, next work ratio. Simple, WT minus WC by WT. That is the net work divided by positive work. Definition of work ratio is net work divided by positive work. So WT, WT1, WC minus WT. So WC, that is CP times T2 minus T1, and WT is CP times T3 minus T4. So CP CP will get cancelled, only temperature will remain. So every temperature you know, just substitute and get the value of work ratio. Okay, here the given volume flow rate will be same, and the mass flow rate also will get cancelled. But next we have to find out the power. So how to find out the power for that? Once again, you just separately you calculate the turbine work, that is actually you have to calculate MFM into CP into T3 minus T4. But what you know, M value they are given constant throughout the cycle. So whatever the value they are given, VF, that is the flow rate in terms of volume, that will remain constant throughout the cycle. Actually, it is not so because fuel will be added and volume flow rate will be F plus A. But when considering the flow rate of air compared to fuel, fuel flow rate will be very less. Air flow rate is the majority dominant and it is taken as constant throughout this cycle. And so, and the finally, you can write multiplication. So WT, you note down CP into T3 minus T4. CP value, you know, T3, you know, T4, you know, just calculate that one. Kilojoule per meter cube. Why you have written meter cube? Because they are given volume flow rate. They are not given mass flow rate. Okay. Otherwise, you could have, kilojoule per, it should be second. Sorry. It should be second. Similarly, WC, kilojoule per second. So power will be flow rate into network. Network means WT minus WC. So volume flow rate VF will be there. So like this you will get, okay, power. Vf 6 into turbine work, compression work, substitute and get the value of power. Okay, so this is how you can have the calculation of power, flow rate into network, that is M into Wt minus Wc. Okay, this is how we are going to find out power. So this is the fifth problem, just a addition to the earlier problem. Till over here is the same, just this part will be added. Okay, so sixth problem, very important problem. So sixth problem, carefully listen this one. In an open cycle gas turbine power plant, air enters the compressor, that is P1, T1 they are given. Pressure after compression they are given P2. Isentropic efficiency of turbine and compressor they are given, eta compression, eta turbine. Air fuel ratio, see, now it is mass flow rate of air and mass flow rate of fuel will come into picture. Okay, now this is how exactly you will understand how we are calculate the power. Okay, so this is how exactly it will be there. So just remember, air fuel ratio, air fuel ratio is nothing but mass of air divided by mass of fuel. Okay, mass of air divided by mass of fuel is equal to 80 ma by mf. They are given 80. Calorific value of the fuel they are given, and mass flow rate of air given, that is ma kg per second. Okay, determine the tool to ask power output of the power plant and cycle efficiency. Assume Cp and gamma value for air as well as combustion product should be same. Okay, now write down the given data. Before writing given data, note down the your cycles, means TS diagrams. So TS diagram will come. So given data, T1 300 Kelvin, P1 1 bar, P2 4 bar, compression, turbine efficiency same as the previous case. Here extra thing is this part they are given, that is air fuel ratio. Air fuel ratio is nothing but mass of air divided by mass of fuel, that is they are given 80. Then calorific value of the fuel they are given, 42,000 kilojoule per kg. Then mass flow rate of air they are given, ma. Okay, the first part will remain same, that is still efficiency formula. No, the same step you have to follow, T2. Before that, pressure ratio, just find out P2 by P1, that is 4 bar only. Next, T2, same procedure. Okay, same procedure you have to follow. T2, just substitute everything, you will get T2. Then once you got the T2, compressor efficiency is there. So compressor efficiency is nothing but ideal work divided by actual work. Ideal work, T2 minus T1, you just check over here in the TS diagram, ideal work. Straight line will be there, so T2 minus T1, and actual work T2 dash minus T1. So just substitute, get the value of T2 dash. Once you got the value of T2 dash, next, this is the case. This is, you carefully listen. See, in earlier previous case, they used to give maximum temperature T3. So here they are not given the maximum temperature. So how to find out that maximum temperature? So heat added means the chemical energy of fuel it has to burn. So what is that energy? That is nothing but mass flow rate of fuel into its calorific value, that is the energy. So that energy will be transferred to heat energy to that in the combustion product. So how much heat energy it is gets converted, that is mass of air plus mass of fuel, that is mass flow rate of combustion product. Remember, mass flow rate of combustion product multiplied by Cp of combustion product multiplied by temperature difference. So that is nothing but T3 minus T2 dash. Initial temperature T2 dash, final temperature after combustion, that is T3, maximum temperature. So this is how you will write the equation, heat added, that is Q1 is nothing but actually MF into Cv. This is the chemical energy. We are not considering any losses. So all the energy will be transferred into heat energy. Chemical energy will be transferred into heat energy. So mass of the fuel will be there. So it will mixes with the air. So exhaust gas produced. So that is mass of exhaust gas multiplied by Cp of exhaust gas into T3 minus T2 dash. Okay.
This is how you will write the equation. So in this equation, take MF outside. So what you will get? MF into CV. This part will be remains same. In this part, MF you have taken outside. So what will become MA by MF plus 1 CP into D3 minus D. So MF, MF will get cancelled. Okay. Then rest all values you know except D3. Okay. So MF, MF will get cancelled. CV, what is the value? 42,000. So C, like this you will get CV into MA by MF plus 1 CP into D3 minus D. So CV value, what you know? 42,000. MA by MF 80 plus 1 CP. They are told to assume same 1.005. Then T3 unknown, T2 dash you have found out, substitute and get the value of T3. So calculation you do and take a note down the value of T3. Okay, this is how we are going to find out T3. So once you get the value of T3, T4 as usual relations are there, T4 and T3, which will relate along with the P3 and P4, our pressure ratio. In terms of pressure ratio, P4 by P3, so that is nothing by 1 by PR. So you will get gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substitute, you will get the value of T4. So once you got the value of T4, turbine efficiency they are given. So turbine efficiency is nothing but just reverse of compression, actual by idle, actual by idle, T3 minus T4 dash T3 divided by T3 by T4. So in this turbine, you know, T3 value, you know, T4 value, you know, T4 dash is unknown. Just substitute and get the value of T4 dash. Okay. So this is how you will calculate all the temperature in this case. Okay. If they are not given value of T3. So how to get the value of T3? Okay. Using mass flow rate. So once you got the value of all the temperature, then it is easy to find out your efficiency. How to find out efficiency? Efficiency, that is the network divided by heat added. Network is nothing but T3 minus T4 dash multiplied by CV divided by minus CP into T2 dash minus T1 divided by heat added, that is CP times T3 minus T2 dash. So all the values you know, CP will get cancelled. So just substitute and get the value of efficiency. Once you got the value of efficiency, next what I told to find out, they told to find out your work ratio and power developed. Work ratio is nothing but network divided by positive work. Network is nothing but turbine work minus compression work divided by turbine work. So you will get like this. So substitute and get the value of work ratio. Okay. So once you got the value of work ratio, next you have to find out power. So power, first individually you find out that is turbine work and compression work. So turbine work, see efficiency is with respect to your per kg, remember. Okay, it is for your entire mass flow rate power. Okay, so turbine work is nothing but, see, 1 to 2 only air is there. Remember how the working principle, just remember 1 to 2 only air is there, 2 to 3 heat added. How it is added? Fuel is burned. Okay, fuel and air will mixes together. Okay, so you will have air plus fuel over here. So once it entering into the turbine, you will have the exhaust gas. So exhaust gas is producing the work like your ICE engine. So initially air will be sucked. Next, diesel fuel is injected, so mass of air and fuel will be there. So later, okay, similar way, your turbine work, okay. So while turbine work is there, it is the exhaust gas. Exhaust gas mass flow rate, how to find out? Whatever mass of air and mass of fuel, you add mass of air plus mass of fuel into CP into T3 minus T4, okay. So this is a turbine work. So mass of air, they are given, that is 2.5. mass of fuel in that equation, MA by MF is equal to 80, that you know, in that MA is 2.5, so MF will be 2.5 divided by 80. So in that equation itself you can find out MF. Rest substitution you do,
that is T3, that is nothing but 998.8, and then you have the T4 dash is nothing but 720.7. So just substitute, get the value of turbine work, that is kilojoule per second. Okay, so next you have to find out similarly compression. See over here, compression work, only air is there. Remember, for turbine exhaust, mass of air plus fuel will be there, whereas compression, only air is there. Remember, only air, mass of air. So Cp T2 minus T1 will be there. So mass of air, you know, 2.5, Cp of air, you know, then T2 dash, that is 482.25, T1, you know, just substitute and get the value of Wc. So power will be already multiplied mass over here, so no need of again multiplying. So just difference between this Wt minus Wc, that will give the power of the plant. So power of the plant is nothing but Wt minus Wc. So this is the power, that is 247 kilojoule per second or kilowatt, 247 kilowatt or 0.247 megawatt. So that is the power of the cycle. So this is how you are going to calculate. So final answer you can write, that is the efficiency of the cycle 18.46, power of the cycle will be, power of the plant will be 247.51 kilowatt. So this is how you are going to find out. So I hope you understood. So basic thing in this problem, what you have to do, first you have to calculate temperature, how you are going to calculate temperature, that is the things. T2, T4, it is very easy. Once you know that formula, it will be very easy. If they are given T3, then fine enough. If they are given adiabatic efficiency of the compressor and turbine, that you have to take care. So actual and theoretical difference, so all those things you have to care. So now today we have studied the basic cycle of the Breton cycle, that is only one regenerative cycle you have studied, problems related to basic Breton cycle and regenerative cycle. So next class, next 6 problem will be combination you may get. So study this video properly, and next class we will talk about combination of reheat, regenerator, intercooler, everything. Okay, so theory portion should be very strong enough. So in this way you have to calculate all the required data based upon the given data. Okay, thank you.